Welcome back, everyone, to more Let's Play Kero Blaster. In the last episode, we took on my favorite stage of the entire game. And in this episode, we're going to be taking on White Laboratories. So let's get started. Alright, so I give up. I'm just gonna go ahead and talk here. There is an optional boss down here, which I will be taking on now. You know what? Screw it. Let's just jump down this hole. Whoa, no! Whatever will I do? Clearly fight this dude because he knows what to do. He too has a jetpack. Oh yeah, wanna see something funny, viewers? You can indefinitely just jump on his head. It's funny. However, I took 2 hearts of damage just for showing that off. First time I discovered that, for some reason it just cracked me up, but anyways, whenever we defeat him, we get 50 coins. Isn't murder great? No, it's really not. Don't do it, please. That'd be terrible. But as you can see, whenever you jump out of here, it's showing you, hey, this is how you should use your jetpack. But we're not going to directly tell you how to use it. You're going to have to figure that out on your own. And that is whenever you have that aha moment. And it is brilliant whenever that happens. Whoa. Ow. Oh, that's bad. And there we go, finally hit the repeat point of that song. By the way, be very careful, viewers, because you can get instantly crushed by these moving platforms, as I have. I didn't want to use that yet. Son of a bud, I was saving it. Oh well, whatever. Anyways, yeah, if you're not very careful, these platforms can instantly crush you. And it has happened to me more than once. So I implore you all to pay attention to where you're going. That was an interesting camera perspective. But yeah, as you see right here, this fan's not moving. And guess what? It holds secrets. Go ahead and open up this safe. You gotta crack it. Uh-oh, the cops are coming. You gotta run. Oh. Well, these guys respawned. And they both gave me 10 coins each. Thanks, guys. Uh-oh. Gotta jump over that fire. Once again, another game mechanic that this game is trying to teach you. You gotta jump over the fire. Oh, and also, the fire will not travel up or down stairs, so you can just stay here indefinitely and be safe. Yeah, see? Like that. So, there we go. Don't want to jump down too soon. That'd be terrible. You know what? I really wonder if I'm going to get any coins out of this. Something tells me, probably not. Well, never mind. I stand corrected. Yeah, but I'll be damned if I try to go down there and get it. It'd be a terrible idea. Whoa. Oh, jeez. Oh, my goodness. I actually saved myself with the jetpack there by some miracle of fate. But either way, I took an unnecessary hit from that mole. But oh well, at least I saved myself from taking a hit earlier. Ah, geez, he's back. And he's got vengeance on his mind. As you can tell, he will throw the bombs depending on which platform you're standing on. There we go. Ultimately, still not too difficult. There we go. Give me that money. I need it. I need to feed my imaginary wife and imaginary three children. Alrighty. Alrighty, righty, righty. What do I want to upgrade? Health? Nah. What about weaponry? I really want to upgrade this to the quad, because whenever you get this bad boy up to level 4, it is amazing. I think I'll go ahead and do that. Sure, let's power it up to the quad. We lose a little bit of attack power, but we get a lot more range. And whenever you upgrade this to the ninja, oh, it's so much fun. Yeah, let's just go ahead and leave. But, yep, see? We now shoot 4 things out. Well, no, I don't want to talk to you. I always found it weird from, like, the perspective, because here it looks just right, but if you shoot straight up, I don't know, it just seems wider than what it is doing this. I think it should have stayed the same, ultimately. Either way, go on ahead and keep going through the stage, shall we? Actually, I take it back. You deal out more damage if you are up close and personal with this weapon. Oh, no, jump back this way. Alright, jump up here. Now you're making noise. I don't like that. Could you please stop it? No! Why did I miss that? Oh, jeez. Whoa! That could have ended terribly for me. Hold on, did I kill him or did his buddy over there kill him? There we go. At this point, I don't even know anymore. Oh, come on, guys. Give me your money! And everything will be A-okay. Oh. Hey, that guy's got a face. Are you okay there, buddy? No? Can I, like, leave you alone? I didn't even know that you could touch him without, you know, taking damage. Whatever. There we go. Gotta teach him a lesson. We gotta make him open up and give us some money. Kero Blaster, teaching people how to mug since 2013. Maybe 2014, I forget whenever this game came out. I think it was 14. Really? I can't. Oh, Jesus! I did not expect to fall down like that, but alas, I did. There we go. And you died? Oh, there goes one thing. Well, goodness. Wah! I do not wish to get any damage taken. Oh, come on. No. Jump up there. I need that money. Yeah. Money becomes quite precious in this game, especially in the later levels. Whenever you're trying to upgrade your weapons to max. Oh. This music sounds awfully familiar. Am I gonna get books thrown at me again? Well, you were knocking stuff off at me, weren't you? Oh! Spoiler alert, yes he does, but I accidentally hit the X button on my Xbox controller. Yeah! And I took damage for it. Come on, game, that wasn't fair at all. There we go. That's for throwing books at me. And you know what? That's for knocking a lamp out, or knocking lights down at me. Fluorescent lights, to be exact. Oh boy. This part right here is a lot of fun, especially if you know what you're doing. I like to activate that, and I just stay right here.
Whee!
And an ow. Well, I took damage either way, but, yeah. I just let the tire do the dirty work for me. As you can see, it one-shots everything in its path. And it is amazing. So, I do not want to take any damage from these guys. Okay, I should have paid attention to where I was going. As you can tell, I did not. Oops. Well, that's what the game over... Well, not the game over screen. There really is no game over screen. You just wake up in a hospital and they just ask you, hey, you want to keep going? And it's like, yes or no. But either way, just gonna stay right here. Yeah, let's not get hit this time. You know, I could have used that heart earlier game. On the bright side, at least I'm getting more money. I suppose that's a plus. Yeah, Jesus. Oh, well, there's another friggin' heart. At this point, I'm convinced that the game is just making fun of me for dying earlier. Yep, come on, I wanna jump up there. And knock these guys out. And by knock them out, I mean murder them. In cold blood. Yeah, no! Now I think I'm like 12 minutes into this recording already. This is by far the longest episode. And I believe that they will only get longer. By the way, you can move faster if you do this. It's really nice. I suggest doing it a lot. Especially for you speedrunners out there. There we go. That particular plant always has a heart for you, so keep that in mind. Alright, so there's no music. We already know what this means. Boss time! And we're going up against a... Oh, jeez. No, I don't want to take any more damage. Please, spare me. Yeah, I see your pattern. By the way, do not stand in front of the vehicle or on the front side of it. If you do, you will die. Also, if you stay on the back side and you get knocked off screen, it's considered instant death. Yes, it's stupid. Yes. I agree. However, for defeating that boss, we get the new weapon, fire. This weapon is strong against cold element enemies and cancels any projectiles. This is by far the best damage dealing weapon in the game, in my own opinion. But I would say a close second, if not slightly better, is a fully upgraded repeater, or the pea shooter. So, with that, we got a flamethrower. We're gonna burn things alive, aren't we? Just listen to that happy music. Alright, well, that's enough of that. Let's go back here and get the extra life that we saw earlier. However, I didn't mention it, because I didn't pay attention. And it's silent again. I don't really like that. However, I got 10 coins. I like that. It's awesome. I'd pay a dollar for that. Huh. I don't like this. This does not look too well. There's only one of you guys, and last time there was three. I want to get out of here. What just happened? Uh-oh. Oh, jeez! Ouch! I think I broke my back and this machine. Tonikawa Hospital. Speaking of game overs from earlier, this is where you will wake up if you get a game over. Yeah, I did wake up. What happened? Was this all a dream? No, I'm pretty sure that my spinal cord is going to retain damage after falling like that and breaking our machine. Well, there's no need to call them things. They have feelings too, I'm sure. Yeah, we've been looking at them a lot lately. Even the president has one. Maybe they're like Pokemon and they're just really popular. Negativus legatia, or legatia, 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 or negative memories or something like that, if I remember right. That is Latin, negativus legatia. Yeah, please explain what they are. I think I already explained it. You recall them pieces of your past that have been cast off. So, like, repressed memories? Of my friend making fun of me? I don't know, I got nothing. Yeah, I agree. They damn near broke my back. They're coming from a broken server. Hold on, how was a broken server responsible for pieces of our memories from our past cast aside? What the hell kind of logic are you? Are you even a scientist, cat? No, you're not. You're a cat. Go play with a ball of yarn. I don't think it's going to be that easy. Yeah, I broke it with my back. It's okay. I'm fine. Hopefully I have medical insurance here. Okay. Here's something for you to wear. Is it a back brace? No, it's a jacket. This item will absorb one attack, and it's worn and quite dapper. Yay, it's a parka. I'll try not to overdo it. No promises, though. Once the server's back online, we'll call you. How are you gonna call me? Do we have cell phones? Cause judging by the telephone systems here, we probably don't. Okay, that explains everything.
Whee!
Yeah, I already mentioned that earlier. Yeah, what are you guys gonna do about that? Okay. Have fun with that. Pink here is, yeah, you're gonna help. I mean, you can shoot stuff. We've already explored this in Pink Hour. Less overtime. That might be a good thing. Unless if you're in Japan, where you have to, like, work 12 to 14 hours work days. 6 days a week. America, we get, like, 40-hour work weeks. In Japan, they get at least 70. On average. Oh, Pink seemed excited to get less overtime, but anyways, that's going to be the end of this episode, so thank you all for sticking around if you did this far into the video, and I'll see you all next time where we will be taking on the Hakichi Plateau. And spoiler alert, we will be using that fire, the flamethrower a lot. Have a good night, ladies and gentlemen.